Getting craft supplies means pooping in the stream world. No, it doesn't. If it did, though, that would be the quickest getting craft supplies session ever. And it just would mean I have plenty of fiber in my diet. Alright. So if you ever do polymer clay... Ah! It's really hot. Ow! Frick. Okay. Nobody wants to hear about your long poops on that stream. Was it long? It didn't seem that long to me. Alright. I'm gonna drop this thing off. She burned herself. Everyone take a shot. Again, if that's... Like, I think y'all need to take better care of your health than that. This stuff looks okay. Not great. Might have to redo the ketchup and the mustard bottles. Alright, so our hot dogs are done. Our little miniature fire is done. I don't need the friend name. Nothing happened. Did you just do it or did you do it earlier? Yeah, because I didn't get an alert. Let me see. Time out, guys. I'm going to see. Nothing happened whilst you were pooping. So you're saying I literally made money pooping? let me see what's going on. Sorry, this is a little technical. Did it go through? Hi. So you admit that you were pooping? No. In the kitchen? I was not pooping in the kitchen. I was just discussing how I'm very particular about my restroom needs. And I need privacy, and I need silence. Yeah. Okay. So straws. This is done. Okay. So last thing we're gonna make is... a sleeping bag and pillow. Let's see. This is like all a mess. It's weird that it didn't go through. Maybe your PayPal account was rejected. So we have a couple choices for fabric. To continue our like Zooey Deschanel of tents theme. Like just a reminder of our color scheme. This term's got you. All right. What I think we're gonna do. Here's our, move this. I wanna make sure I don't have stuff over. Okay. So, I think we're gonna use this for the outside of the sleeping bag, and in fact I have a little, hush, you didn't wanna come up here. So there's our inspiration pick. I'll be honest, I'm looking at it now, I don't know if that's what I want to do. I think I'm just going to do something a little more basic and just fold it. So I think this will be the outside, and this will be the inside, maybe? Do you see that? Like, imagine that as a... I think I like it. And then a white pillow. I think so. Okay. So... I think this stuff's cool. Aww. Turned out very cute. So we'll put this stuff over by our fire. Actually, let me cut this. Oh, no, wait. Before we do the sleeping bag, let's do this plastic experiment. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to take this and we're going to melt it and see if we can make a little plastic bag for our extra buns. I think I want white. Like, what I'm trying to do is figure out where I want to cut it. Sounds dangerous. Yeah, this is definitely, especially with like a high-powered, an extra strength hot glue gun, this might not work out great. But I really wanted to at least try it and see. I'm sure that the chemicals that I will be releasing with this are not good for me or the environment. I'm hoping it's not enough to affect the environment, but I guess I'm also hoping it's not enough to affect me. There it is! Poops McGee! Please read this in your best British accent. Hold on. It was too short. Please read this in your best British accent. I'd like to name the hot dog Lieutenant Thackeray Loddington. You can't, no, the hot dog's not up for naming. I have nowhere to memorialize the name of the hot dog. Lieutenant Thackeray Loddington. How would you even think of that? Oh my God, that's hilarious. All right. Oh no, this is not lined up properly. Let's see. Sorry, I paid good money for that name. Honestly. Duh. Alright. Let me get a plate for Thackeray Loddington. Where is it? This is something I made a little while ago that... I present Lieutenant Thackeray Loddington. Can't eat it now that you've named it either. I probably won't eat this. So now we have Lucifer and his hot dog. There. Alright. I need a ruler. It's Lieutenant! They don't say Lieutenant. All right, I think I'm gonna make this an inch wide. All Lieutenant. That's his Christian name. His parents say Lieutenant. So that's not a title. That's actually his name. So do they call him Lefty for short? Lieutenant. It's Lieutenant in other countries. Is it? With an F? Lieutenant. I'm obviously not up on the international titles. Burn. You're just excited because someone else agreed with you. Besides, you said it was his name. You said it wasn't his title. You said it was his name. Alright, here's our bag. I think I'm gonna remove the tape from this thing. I think it's spelled the same. Yeah. Let's see. I'm really not sure how this is gonna work out, guys. Well, actually, I'm somewhat sure how it's gonna work out, and it's not. Wait, we have to take a shot for that burn. Both emotional and physical burning sensations. All right. I'm gonna say yes. It's your Monday. It's your Monday after. All right. So I think I'm gonna like do it along the white line here and then give it a little bit across the edge. And then I can shorten it if I need to. All right, this is happening. With the world's hottest hot glue gun. Where's Jay Hackett? That guy is a hoot. I don't know, I don't know where he went. Maybe he had somewhere he had to go. My cat is laying in the middle of the floor looking like a beach whale. Let's see. I wonder if I can. She looks like a walrus.
Hey! Hey! What are you doing?
That's an example of my swivel cam action. Feeling pretty good about that. Can you show her to us? Can you pick her up? I already picked her up. You missed it. She was much better this week than she was last week. There was less clawing and more just like generalized anxiety. And I felt bad, and so I put her down. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna, I don't know if this is gonna work. I feel like this is gonna be a disaster. I'm hoping that this will help, like, stop the plastic from melting all the way. No, it's not even lined up right. Let's try this again. Alright, here we go. So this is plastic bag melting. Take one. Ooh! Oh, you guys couldn't see that, could you? Let's try this. Let's try this again. All right. I think it's working. Again, I'm sure these chemicals aren't great. And it definitely smells like burning. But you know what? This is what we have to do for art. What's your most favorite mini project that you've done so far? My favorite mini project is probably my miniature farm stand, because the inspiration for it was a gift. My cousin gave me just some little miniature fruits and veggies. And then I was like, and she had originally said, oh, you should make a garden out of it. And I was like, I could do a garden, or I could do a little farm stand. And so I did that. And then, in fact, I made a background for it. I think it worked. Let's take this tape out. It worked. Can you show us the stand?
I think I know where it is.
Let's see.
What?
It's all packed up, but you can see. Yeah. And then I have this opens up, and then this has a little roof. The props, and drop the other toothpick. And then I had a bunch of I have some really cool little signs on the side. And I was pretty pleased with that. I did that with jump rings. And then some more over here. That's another cool thing about living in Texas is all the different farm stands. And I was really proud of myself for inventing how to do miniature corrugated steel. So yeah, that's probably my favorite project so far. And it didn't take too long. That's the good thing about miniature projects is you can finish them really quickly. Kind of like this miniature bag of bread. Too cute. Thank you. A lot of the other miniature projects I did was just themed furniture, because I was decorating. I have this little house in the background, and I would just decorate it for the holidays. But that's less fun than a whole scene, which is why I've switched. Switch to doing more themed compositions in the word of. Oh, Tim Holt! I forgot about my lantern. Can we request future projects? I was soliciting ideas earlier. I'm almost scared to ask what you would suggest. I totally donate for that. Yeah, but no. There's none of this here you give money and then I have to make whatever scene you're thinking of. That would be, I'm guessing it would be a dominatrix's dungeon or something, and I don't need to have to track down that much miniature pleather. Innocent face, yeah, I'm sure. So I'm trying to melt the other side now. This is pretty cool, actually. This is kind of neat. If you need really hyper-realistic miniature plastic bags, this is not a bad way to go. I did buy a pyrography tool, which is for burning wood, because that's what I saw the instructions online for. And then I was like, wait a second, I've got the world's hottest hot glue gun. I bet this will work. Nobody wants to see 50 Shades of Minis. I feel it'd be really funny, but I'm not doing clothing right now. Trying to make miniature clothing is beyond my patience level. So I'm afraid that their outfits would just... Without the outfits, it just wouldn't be worth it. Okay. So now... I'd like to request that you make a replica Wes Anderson scene of Minnie's. So I have thought about doing like movie scenes. That would be pretty fun. Like something from, I love Wes Anderson. Just like his whole like style, like obviously. Like, yes, like obviously I love Wes Anderson. I requested a bookshelf, but apparently I haven't. I didn't say that. I said that I would want to come up with enough books that are like puns and plays on words to fill up the shelf. Here's the problem. I'm just realizing what the problem with this plan is. Is you can't see through the plastic. I might need to cut this shorter. Oh, and it's coming out of the side. I don't know if this plastic bag's gonna work. Like the ZC or something. That would be fun. I have the books. I was saying we could do a combination coffee shop bookshelf. I might have made this plastic bag too small. Short. Please make sure the Wes Anderson scene includes a bookshelf. I bet the submarine in Life Aquatic had a bookshelf in it somewhere. I love that movie. I love how they like, it kind of like almost has like a dollhouse feel to it, how they have it structured. Or diorama. So, technically, I'm doing miniatures, but I'm leaning more towards like dioramas than dollhouses. But I still appreciate dollhouses. All right. There's our plastic bag. I don't know. I feel like this is not. I might need to come up with a better way to store our loaves of bread. I just have to get it like a little paper bag or something. Aww, it's just like a little Ziploc baggie. All right, I think this idea is better for like a lunch bag. We're just gonna have to have our bread sitting out on a plate or something, along with our hot dogs. But at least we tried. All right, how's our ketchup and mustard looking? We got our ketchup or mustard. So the books I have, so here's how I've been, like, look at this. This is super cute. You can buy these like jewelry things to like organize all your stuff. And then this was one of my punny titles. I need a thinner pen though. Jane Hare. And then yeah, like I wanted to just like write a title, like some kind of animal punny title on all of these. And then I have another bookshelf somewhere too. The good thing about these books is that they're not a pain to move. Like, Unlike real books, which are like way more than bricks. Alright. Hot dogs. Hot dog buns. Hot dog buns. Let's make our sleeping bag real quick. And then we'll be all done. So, let's make it for Jimi Hendrix. Here's the stand-to-sit functionality of this desk I paid too much for. Oh. You guys can't see it, but I have... I have a light propped on the back of this, and it totally just moved. Yes, they're super cute. I do have like a bunch. In fact, somewhere I have a bookshelf of just like a bunch of books. Let's see. I don't know where it is though. I'll have to find it. I'll find it for our Wes Anderson themed bookshelf. So now, let's see. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just like cut a piece for the top and a piece for the inside and glue them together because why not? I have a sewing machine, but it's kind of a piece of crap. And so I try not to use it that often because like the amount of effort you have to put in to get the tension right is just like hardly worth it. So if we do a pillow today, I'll be hand sewing it. Which, luckily, because it's a miniature, it won't take too long, but, we'll see how it works. Okay. So, I'm going to... Alright, where's my rotary cutter? Rotary cutter. It's somewhere around here. The problem with these things is they're see-through. This thing. I keep on focusing on every sound I hear from my home. I'm gonna make it 6 inches. 4, 5, 6. So then it can like fold over him. Is that too much? No, that seems right. And I'll make it 6 inches. 3 inches? Yeah. 6 by 3. Again, this This is one of the good things of working with the rotary cutters and the rulers, is it's really easy to get the exact size you need. So 6 inches. 3 inches. Why did you name your mini Lucifer? I did not name the mini Lucifer. Jay Hackett named him Lucifer, and it's spelt differently. So I don't think it's a reference to that Lucifer. So it was suggested last week that we could let some of the viewers name the minis in exchange for donations. And so for $10, you can name your one of the animals, whatever you want, within like a limited amount of rules. And I said no profanity and no like sexism or racism or anything like that. I did not include no words that sound like religious references. So we may, I mean, maybe we want to reconsider the rules. It's something to consider. Is it a I hope that wasn't loud. Sorry, it's like right next to the microphone. All right. So now I'm gonna iron this under and then glue it all together. It's a religious dream. It's not a religious dream. Beyond just me praying that it works out okay and that I don't hurt myself too much. That's probably the only religion that's involved. In fact, I think you're the one who suggested we could name the minis for donations. And I think it's super fun. I like it. I was told that you did squat challenges on the stream. Oh, really? Who told you that? Speaking of which, for those 11 people online right now, Poops McGee, after last week's of my stream, my very first stream ever, and I was really excited and I really loved it, and then he decides to live stream his reactions to the recording of my stream. And then he decided to like find other streamers who were doing interesting things and give me some advice on like other things I might want to try. So let me give you an example of the kinds of things he was suggesting, because I did get a screenshot of this because it was too hilarious not to. Poops McGee. Look at that. You don't recall this, really? You don't recall that screenshot? yeah. Yep. So thank you. Every time you get sassy, I'm gonna pull that up. Dear viewers, this was clearly shopped. Oh, I didn't need to shop that. No. If I had shopped it, I would have done a much better job. In PowerPoint. And the worst part is you only live streamed the first half, which was the worst half of the very first broadcast I ever did. You didn't even get to like when it got good. Okay, so I'm just folding this under so that they'll have like nice clean edges, and then I'm gonna use something you probably don't expect inside, because this is like where miniatures diverge from like dolls. So like if you're making something like for a Barbie doll for a kid, like you want it to feel like soft and like fun to play with. With miniature configurations, in the words of Tim Holt, That's a reference to last week for those of you who weren't there. The whole thing was equally awesome. That's nice of you to say, but I don't believe that. When you're working with miniatures, it won't lie correctly. Like, it'll look weird, and it'll kind of pop up, because it just doesn't have enough gravity or weight to, like, lay, like, oh my god, what is... I don't understand why this... Dear viewers, if this ironing board falls on me, and I get burnt by this iron, please come save me. And no, I'm not going to tell you my address. One of you must know where I live. All right. All right, so now... I think that's gonna work out very well. Actually, I'm gonna get ready to drink. If this iron falls on me, I don't think anyone's gonna laugh. Like, burning your finger with a hot glue gun is one thing, but having an iron on heat level 6, that's probably a little intense. All right, so I think that's good. All right, so now the trick to making miniature sleeping bags and blankets and stuff that is just it's not really actually gonna be played with, it's just for like show and like a miniature thing. Set your irons to heat level 6. Things are gonna get serious. You wanna use foil inside. Because it lets you mold it. And so then you can like mold it around whatever character you're doing. Little tip if you're interested in pursuing your own miniatures in the future. You're probably not, because this is a very particular hobby. God, I don't need a drink. Bye, Girl Phoenix Rising. Thank you. Okay. Ooh, I totally just melted. Look at this. Okay, I need a new glue gun. I just melted the tape dispenser. Listen, can you see that? I don't think you can. That's not great. All right, so now I'm just gluing my edges to each other. Basically, I'm just gluing this so that this will be the lining and this will be the outside. Enjoyed it. Thank you. All right. So if we were doing this for real, we'd probably sew this, but no, I'm not gonna do that. That's fine. This is adorable. Like, this is almost too cute. If that was a thing, this would be it. Too cute. All So now I'm gonna like fold this up. Because again, you want it to be something you can mold. Because like if I just wrap this, where's Jimi? Jimi Hendrix. So if I just wrap this around him right now, like look at this. No, you can't see that. It just looks like a piece of fabric. Like you can very easily tell that this is not a sleeping bag. And I'm all about realism here. At Reptile Dysfunction, I'm all about the most realistic miniatures. I'm not. It's not true. Is it true that if you cut foil with scissors, it sharpens them? I think that might be true. Just wrap them on your college day. It's like a baked potato. A baked hedgehog. There's a joke in here. A hedgehog potato joke. I can't find it though. Had been, I would have found it, I'm sure. I would have. Oh, that I love this song. Set Myself Ablaze for You. When I selected it, I don't know that I actually listened to it. It's not great. Derek Clegg is encouraging weird things. There we go. Oh, still needs to be a little. See, the song was around my head. If I get far enough along, I'll start doing themed playlists. But getting the outro video to like sync with it all is more work than you would probably imagine it would be. This is still too wide. Dark stream. Yeah, I'm much darker online than in real life. Okay. I'm trying to get it to like be as close to the edges as it can be. There. So now I can like mold this around him. See? Oh, Jimmy's loving it. You see that? Alright, let's glue this edge down. Thermal blanket. What? No, space blanket. That's what it is. This is a space blanket. This thing's like hanging off. All right. Go ahead and just glue this at the bottom. Alright. Have you ever talked to your minis as if they're real people? Do you ever wish they're real? I've never talked to my minis as if they're real people. I have talked to my cat like she can understand me. When she attacked the vet last time I took her in, I told her she better not get sick again because I don't necessarily want to pay $300 for them to have to, like, put her to sleep just to, like, feel her tummy. So she got a very firm talking to after that. And if I were a mini witch critter, would I be? You know the answer to that one, the last one? If I were a mini, I would be, I don't know what I'd be. Something amazing. I'd be a little mini dinosaur. That's what I'd be. If I had my choice. Do kids still watch, like, Land Before Time? Is that still a thing? That was the other dinosaur movie I was thinking of when I was, like, trying to think of, like, sound clips to include in my alerts. But that was such a sad movie. I'd be surprised if people are still watching it. What's the crankiest of the critters? I don't think any of them are cranky. They're all adorable. Well, Lucifer's probably not super not cranky just because his name is unfortunate. All 50 of them. I don't know that I saw past, so I saw Land Before Time 1 and I might have seen Land Before, like, number 2. I don't know if I saw past that. Can you see that? Oh my god. I'm gonna turn him. Oh. Oh, Jimmy. Jimmy Hendrix. I don't know that I need a pillow. I also don't know that I have room for a pillow in here. I'm going to stick this in. Alright, sleeping bag. This thing's really heavy, actually. And then we got our little hot dog. And our plate. Where's our other place? Jimi Hendrix. Yes. Waylon's mom. Waylon's mom named him. It's a great name. Let's see. I don't know how many hot dogs I really need. I have a plate with, like, a couple extra hot dogs. There we go. And then some extra buns. Little hot dog. That little hot. That wasn't agreed upon at the time. Lieutenant Thackeray Loddington? Was that it? Lieutenant Thackeray Loddington. I think it's a little bit grand of a name for this particular hot dog. And then we have our ketchup and our mustard. Alright, next time someone asks me the worst miniature I ever made, I'm gonna name this failure of condiments. And I might just go put a comment on that woman's project and say it did not work. And I almost burned my house down. All right. I think $10 is a little grand. You did that on your own. Like, that was not, that was all you. Let me move this all forward. All right. I feel pretty good about this. We got Lieutenant. Let's prop this up. Yeah, this is bad. I need new bottles. And then our tent. And we got, you know, if you get a Goodwill for that kind of thing. I do, because I just spent $10 at Goodwill yesterday and got something pretty awesome. Where's Lucifer? There he is. Lucifer. Is it better if I pronounce, like, the double R's? I think it might be better. Alright. I think we're done. I was gonna do a pillow, but I don't feel like I need it. I feel pretty good about this. Next week, so planning on streaming next Sunday, same time. And we'll do some little fishing gear, so this turns into like a little fishing campground. Again, thanks everybody for watching. I know for a fact I know some of you in real life, so thank you for being here. And those of you I don't know, my name's Lindsay. I live in Houston, and you can check out my blog and stuff like that at lindsayarons.com. And I will see you next week.
Comes the sunset.